Tonight, I would like to welcome you to the 1986 production of Folly, Live Singers Reach the Beach. Before we begin, I'd like to recognize the following people. Mr. Sam Chandler, principal of SBHS. Ms. Jane Martin, SBHS drama teacher. Mary Helen Birdwell and Bill Miller for taking our accompaniment. 1001 Printing for Program. Hardy's and McDonald's for all their donations this year. First Baptist Church for rehearsal facilities. Coca-Cola Bottling Company, and last but not least, the parents of Life Singers for donating their children. This year's Folly will help us raise money for our tour to Myrtle Beach in June. Join us now to give our impression of what our trip will be like when Life Singers reach the beach.
This is what the beach and the ocean look like. I never thought it could look like this. I have seen pictures of the ocean and the beach, have even seen it in the movies. But this is something out of this world. I really do think now that today is going to be a very special day. I can hardly wait.
Get around, round, round, I 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 get spoken wise to you now.
I now shall
have since you took your set of keys, you've been thinking that your fun was all through
should
now.
I now have
oh, won't you come along with me, cause I got a lot of things to do
should
now.
afternoon drags on and as the sun gets hotter, the group stops turning to the water and also in getting in tan. The girls are interested with the happenings on the beach, and most of all in one man's sunglasses, which are quite unusual. Surfing is being enjoyed by the group, and even the guys join in to sing that special Surfer Girl, which is followed by a surfer party.
Come on, girls, let's go get us a real man.
Thank you. now, everybody's learning now. Come on, it's a boy with me. Early in the morning we'll be starting out. The parties will be coming along. We're loading up the woody with the board design. We're heading down and singing a song. Come on, baby, wait and see. Yes, I'm gonna take you surfing with me. Lonesome, baby, wait and see. Yes, I'm gonna take you surfing with me.
Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on, a safari with me.
In Huntington and Lotto, we're shooting the beer. In Utah, they're walking the snow.
Eat it. On behalf of the Light Singers of Shelbyville, we'd like to thank you for coming and welcome you to the exclusive fashion review of 1986. Here comes Gottfried, modeling our new line of Day Bear. And Gottfried returns, modeling our exciting swimwear. I wish I could go swimming with her. And once again, for a final appearance, Gottfried models our hot evening wear. Ooh, that's marvelous, darling. What are you doing tonight? Oh, I think you have to tell those people something.
We will now have a 15-minute intermission. Refreshments are in the lobby. Thank you.
Marks the 15th anniversary of Light Singers. Conceived in concept by Miss Betty Chatham, given birth by the first group of high school age young people with the desire to share their belief in Jesus Christ, nurtured by parents much like yourselves who give up their time, their patience, their love, and their dedication, and supported by the oh so many good and wonderful people of Shelby County, Life Singers is now a thriving teenager, much like many of the members of our cast tonight. Without the initial support of the patrons of Life Singers, we would not be in a position tonight to present this 1986 Follies. One of those who shared the love and the desire to see the young people to give their testimony for Christ was Mr. Jack Lawson. And tonight, we dedicate this performance to the memory of Mr. Lawson with our love and with our gratitude for his continual support. We're in the final days now of our 1985-1986 season, and it'll come to a close on June the 18th when we return from our South Carolina trip. This outstanding group of 33 young people from 15 churches throughout the county will have met 34 times to practice, will have performed their concert 15 times in front of 7 different Christian denominations. They will have washed cars, wrapped Christmas presents, prepared baked goods and sold them. They will have played a basketball game. They will have painted faces and sold balloons in the rain at the Dogwood Festival. And even somewhere find the motivation to get up and attend a 6:30 a.m. Easter morning sunrise service to present their concert. This organization is open to all high school age young people with a desire to share their faith in Jesus Christ. At the beginning of the school year, tryouts are held every year. The time, place, and date of those tryouts are announced here at the high school. We invite any young person in high school that wants to be a part of this organization, that wants to share their belief in Jesus Christ with the members of other churches throughout the county, to come and audition, regardless of your musical background. To the wonderful people of Shelby County, to you who have come tonight to share with us this wonderful beach party, we say thank you for supporting us.
Good evening. For those of you who may not know who I am, who are wondering who this person is madly waving his arms down here, I'm Ricky Allen, director of Life Singers. And it is my privilege at this time to present a couple of awards. We're out here all week long, those of you that are former Life Singers on the grounds here. you here tonight know what follows with so much fun and excitement. And so many parents that are allowed to see it out here that have been through a Follies Week know how much fun and excitement we have out here, right? Right here all week long, usually from 6 o'clock until around 9. This year's been easy. We have left here at 9 o'clock every night, surprisingly. A lot of nights in the past have been 10 and 30, sometimes the things don't work real well. But we build our own set, we put everything together, and have a lot of fun. Most of the music, hopefully, is prepared before we start. But it's a lot of work that the kids have. They have planned and planned their own. All the decisions, songs, and everything is up to the seniors. Up to the ones that are star on the back of the program. They've been a part of the college planning committee, and I thank them for that. They've done a good job, and it's kind of their legacy that they leave for this year's college is up to them. And it's nice. It's a good thing to leave with. So during this week, each of the individual life singers vote for the boy and girl that they think did the best to show to the world, to the community around them, and in life singers what the standards of life singers are, and how they feel that their own peers stand up to these standards. So they choose one of each, one boy and one girl, to be chosen as the outstanding life singer for the year. And here with me are Paul Trammell and Jim Axeline, who are last year's recipients. We're going to begin another little tradition here where the previous year we'll present these CSC awards to the people that have been chosen. We've been blessed throughout the years, through 15 years, of having a lot of families that have had several members of the families that have joined in the last year as part of it. And this year is no different. We have I think both of our recipients have had a clean sweep in their families, that every member, at one time or another, has been belonging to Last Singers. The young lady that there's one this year is the last in line, in a long legacy to not have somebody like us in this family. And I'd like for Faye Fulton to come out with this.
After
she graduates, she goes,
"Do you want to hear
this after this?" It would be strange not to have a hope for it unless it's been there from the very beginning. And the next person, as I said, is maybe not the end, almost the end, right near the end, but his family has had a complete clean sweep of all the members and parents and everything else is on with it. So I want Fuji Kako to not be able to join us. We have grown to be friends, have grown close in the group, and the tears will probably come tonight as this is our last call. And another person that I forgot to acknowledge last night, because I would like to, without him you could not hear us, sitting about a third of the way back in the audience here. Richie Sykes has been our sound man and did a terrific job. Yay. Everything we have is on tape tonight. All of our accompaniments are taped. It's all seven to find the piano, to move the grain out of the core serving and everything else down here. It makes it a little easier, unless we have a few technical problems around for any of those. I hope not. I mean, if I'm thinking a light wouldn't come on, I'm a little late getting out here. But those things happen. This is not a professional show by any means. We try to do our best, but we're having fun, we're entertaining, and we hope you enjoy the rest of our program. Thank you.
Thank you.
lucky as you march down the road to Jerusalem. There were tears in your eyes, from the same one to tears, yet crucified. But not even death could hold you down, 'cause on that third day you rose from the ground.
Forever be.
know nothing seems to go on my cousin doesn't care about me. And I don't have any friends to see. I think it would be better if I was drowning myself. Then I wouldn't be bothering you anymore. Oh, girl, please help me. I just don't want to leave you anymore.
David, you know you never have to go that way. Because you know that God's always going to help you through whatever problem that you go through. Let me read you something. I'll let you put it. It's a little story called Footprints. One night a man had a dream. He dreamed he was walking along the beach with the Lord. Across the sky flashed scenes from his life, where he seemed to know two sets of footprints in the sand. One belonged to him, and the other to the Lord. When the last scene of his life flashed before him, he looked back at the footprints in the sand. He noticed that many times along the path of his life, there was only one set of footprints. He also noticed that it happened at the very lowest and saddest times in his life. So this really bothered him, and he questioned the Lord about it. Lord, you said that once I decided to follow you, you'd walk with me all the way. But I've noticed that during the most troublesome times of your life, there was only one set of footprints. I don't understand why, when I needed you the most, you would leave me. Then the Lord replied, my precious, precious child, I love you, and I will never leave you. During your times of trial and suffering, when you see only one set of footprints, it is then I carried you. See, Jerry,
we all go through problems in our life. We have the good times and the bad times. It seems like when we go through the bad times, they just don't seem like they're bearable. And that's one reason why Jesus came into this world, to make it bearable for us. So he would bear our problems, our burdens, our sins. You know, one thing I know is that when I'm going through a tough time, and this happens, say, well, thank you, Lord, anyway, for allowing me to go through that. Just praising for you. It makes all the difference in the world. Jake, next time when you go through a problem that gets you down, try to praise the Lord and just see how far you will go.
Powerless behind you. Thank you. say it's myth and legend, one more book upon the shelf. But the message it contains cannot be stilled. For God, who wrote its pages, will not let it pass away. Not one syllable will linger unfulfilled.
His word will stand. Thank you.
Temporary, very meaningful musical for us this year. It's meant a lot to us. We thank you for coming, but before we leave, we have a little tradition. Now, we're a available tradition in Life Singers. We've got so many. But this one is pretty special for us because it's our chance to thank you for coming. First year we did this, back before Noah. We, isn't that long? I guess Betty's not here tonight, I can say that. She chose this song one year, and it just has kind of sunk in with us as a final benediction for everything that we do. This is the last thing we do. For the last night of tour, or the last night that we, before we get off the bus, last night of filing, whatever, it's just a very meaningful benediction. We'd like to ask any former Life Singers that are sitting around out in the audience that to come join us, all former, present, etc. Life Singers, to join us on stage as we give our last number of benediction to you. It's simply called Grace to You. So grace to you, grace to you, God's grace, grace to you. As you walk through your life in joy or in strife, God's grace to you. Grace in the verse peace, and the final verse love. So as you scattered around, there's many of you sitting out there that are former Life Singers. Come on up on the stage and join us. I'm looking at two sitting right now here. They can come up here. Three. Yeah. Four. Now come on. Yeah. He's pointing outside anyway. How many more we got out here? That's about it. I guess we gotta get Richie up here too. As soon as he starts to sing, then he'll join us. But thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting us throughout the years. As you have, we've enjoyed your support both spiritually and financially. So our benediction to you, grace to you. Oh.